Sharks Elite! Well, we brought some sunshine with us today. You guys haven't seen the sun in about a decade. I feel the same way, because we live in fucking Vancouver, where the cocksucker never decides to show itself. Oh, let me guess. Let me guess what you did on a sunny Saturday. You guys have been drinking all day, haven't you? You guys have the afternoon buzz that's turning into the evening buzz that's going to turn into a domestic dispute later.
Please don't.
Please don't. Don't do that.
Let's not make the news tomorrow.
Don't do that. Well, tell me something. What you guys think of Cedar? Good. You know what? I'm going to go up this staircase and not walk towards the end. My logic behind this is I always say, you know what? They unloaded all the trucks. They set all this shit up. I should at least walk around on it once. I think we're going to jam a song off an album we had called All the Right Reasons. We're going to try and get everybody singing along. Even those of you that are already intoxicated, don't worry if you don't know the words. Just fucking hum along. It'll be fine. This song is called Photograph. On a Saturday! Should we do another song off of All the Right Reasons?
No, let's change it up.
No? Okay. What do you want to do? Do you really want to change it up?
I kind of do.
You can play whatever you want. What do you want to do? No. Now? We can do whatever you want. Whatever you want, buddy. It's your big day.
Is it?
It's your big day.
I'm feeling good.
Sure. Do you want to hold off on this one? Do you want to play something else?
I think we're going to move this. I think I will derail it if I decide to play it.
Well, we can call an audible later.
We'll talk about this later.
We'll talk
about it. We should talk about it in front of the kids.
Right, not in front of the kids. Exactly. All right. Well, then I think we should play a song that... we really enjoy when the girls scream along to. That's what I'm screaming about. But this song is called Far Away.
You know, you know.
glad you guys did most of the singing. I've got some in my throat. Bradley!
Let's fix this.
Yeah, we gotta get that out of there. It's just stuck there. I think it's time for alcohol to just clear the passage.
I feel kind of sad I missed that.
You sad you missed it?
Oh, I didn't hear it. I didn't know what it was.
It started doing its own thing. It just sort of jumped off.
I want to sing a different song. All right.
I think the universe was actually trying to tell us we were supposed to sing a different song. Nothing like a Jaeger bomb to really flush the pipes.
Doctor's orders, Chad.
Exactly.
Cheers!
Brad, keep those coming. My doctor says I need those every 5 minutes. All right. Let's change up the set now. Now what do you want to do? Now what do you want to play? I have my sparkling guitar, so I think we have to do this one. So, let me just give you just a tiny bit of background about this song. See, when it comes to writing lyrics, these are the kinds of songs that will get you absolutely fucking hated on the internet. See, when we sit around and we write this stuff, we come up with this stuff. Some of these things, I laugh myself to sleep. Just think they're absolutely hilarious. And while we're sitting around in the studio, and sometimes this shit comes out of my mouth, and we write it down and we sing it, and then I look at the other guys and say, can you imagine if this gets played on the radio? It got played on the radio. It went to number one and sat there for a while. And I took the advice of Tommy Lee on one drunken evening.
That sounds like a terrible
idea. Tommy and I are buddies. Like the two of us are two peas in a pod. And he says, Chad, if you get one song off of every album that gets played in a strip club, you're gonna have a really long career. And what I wasn't doing, I wasn't questioning the source. I should have been saying to him, yes, but you're the drummer from Motley Crue. And that's how you wind up with songs with the phrase, you look so much cuter with something in your mouth in it. We'll be right back. Silly shit. More silliness. Or we can just play serious songs for the rest of it. There's gotta be some levity in here.
Hello, darkness, my friend.
You go what?
You sounding the girl on? No?
Oh.
No? Anyone? No?
Yeah,
alright.
Okay. Oh, is that what you just did?
Hello, darkness, my friend.
We went to a bar the other night, or a lab, or talk, and walked in, and we're like, let's check this out. And go down to it. Daniel goes down and walks in. Ah, let's see this thing. He's got some action here, opens it up, dead empty. And it's like, hello, darkness, my little friend. Was that actually playing when he walked in?
The line was playing. It's like,
oh, truly.
No, no, let's go around the block. Let's check another place out.
It's like,
no offense, I like Simon and Garfunkel, but I was in for a good time, not a sleepy time.
Yeah, it is. Then you open up a door, there's fucking AC/DC cranked, and the place is packed, and everyone's doing shots, and you're like, now we're talking!
If I was going to cry into my beard, that would be just perfect.
Single tear just drops right into your beard. So. Alright.
None of that shit. Let's play
none of that shit! Let's get into a fun rocker. You know it's gonna be worth a laugh when the first line starts off like this. I like your pants around your feet. Go! Thank you so much, Leeds! All right. Well, someone came up with the idea that we should play a song off of every single one of our albums. I think on this tour, no, I think actually just in the UK, I think that's the promise we made. We're only gonna do that in the UK, just special for you guys. No one else gets it. Okay, I'll play it. Some guy in the background just screams some song from our very first demo. I'm like, all right. Sold, we'll do it. So when I was a kid, I used to do a lot of mushrooms. Kid? Okay, last year I probably did a lot of mushrooms too. But
I actually meant maybe teenage years.
Yes, that's what I mean.
I do agree.
That's what I mean.
Last year. Oh, okay. And last year too.
No.
What he means is I've been doing mushrooms my whole life.
No. 16, 17. They grow in a field, for Christ's sake. It's better than the shit that they cook in bathtubs these days. Who are you going to trust, man or God?
You're talking about the shit that goes on pizzas, right?
Yes, I'm talking about pizza toppings. That's correct. Anyway, so when you, it really kind of opens your mind to some shit. And when you're holding a guitar and you're tripping balls, you come up with stuff like this. And this is a song that was on our very first, not album, but demo. 7-song demo that we recorded in like 1995. You weren't even fucking born yet. This song's called Leader of Men.
Tell your friends not to think out loud until they swallow. Whisper things into my brain. Your voice sounds so hollow. Turn your tail.
much! Now, since we're going to play a song off of every single album, we wanted to play something off of an album we had called No Fixed Address. So, what we try and do a lot of times when we're making records is we'll try and do something that's just a little bit out of the norm. So, like, when we first recorded Rockstar, for instance, that was not something we normally would have done. And, we, you know, with every album, we try and take one little step to the left or a step to the right. We just try some different shit. We don't know. I mean, we like it. We don't know if you guys are going to like it or not, but it's worth a shot. So we tried something on that album that I was just talking about. And I was like, you know what? I want to try something a little funky. And I was like, don't play anything funky. Rock and roll and nothing but. We're going to play something funky.
What he means to say is, and now for something completely different.
And now for something completely different. So we recorded a song called She Keeps Me Up. And we're going to try that one for you guys. Here we go.
Come on.
person to being funky. When that record first came out, and I'm like, because I love that song, and it was just so fun to record, it was fun to write, I'm like, let's play this live, and they're all looking at me like, I don't know, I'm like, nah, fuck it, let's do it. We played that song live, on that tour, like that record just came out, and everyone was just looking at us like, is this Casey and the Sunshine, is this Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch?
We could have named it Career Suicide.
We could have called it Career Suicide.
Yeah.
That's just us pissing around. Ah! Now, I think it's time for a little karaoke. I think we should find out if somebody out there wants to come up here and sing Rockstar with us.
I gotta watch out.
It's
help,
like,
help her.
It's like she just got picked for The Price is Right. That was great.
There's no money in it.
There's no money involved in this whatsoever. Who else is coming? We gotta get. All right. You what? You said I've already been up, is that what you said? Oh, that dumb quote. Oh, now I recognize you. Because we spend the whole first part of
it.
He's singing every fucking word. I'm like, he knows the shit. I'm going to
win the chances.
Well,
one more.
I'm predictable. You pick one. Hi, how are you?
Hello.
Okay. And you are?
Nicole.
Give it up for Nicole. Yes. Careful.
Help the gentleman.
Watch his teeth. Jump on up. Come on up. Yeah, no, come on up.
A very expensive stairs there. Come on up. Oh, all right.
We had him right there.
God damn it.
What happened there?
It's not OSHA approved.
I feel like we were just fishing in the line to... Oh, shit. What's your name, brother?
Zach.
Give it up for Zach!
Zach
and Nicole.
In your biggest outside voice, say hello to Leaves.
Hello, Leaves!
You know what? You would be very good at a Slayer concert.
You would be great. That was amazing, dude. If you do that for me for the rest of the show, hello, Leaves!
I like it.
Usually we get someone up here, and you know, occasionally Ryan will say that to me. Hi, everybody. I'm like, no, it's your fucking testicle voice. Okay. So now, when you guys speak into those microphones, the only way you're going to hear yourself is through that little monitor right there. Okay? Because we got these. Now, if you know the song well enough and you don't care, you can Snoop Dogg all up and down this mofo. If not, stay right there. Hold on to Nicole. Nicole, hold on to him. I know, Nicole, he's cute, but you're going to have to let him go by the end of the song. All right, we're going to do this one in G. You guys ready?
Ready.
Leeds, are you ready?
Woo!
All right, let's give this a try. Here we go.
I'll need a
guys having fun? You having a good time, Nicole? Zach, how you feeling, brother?
You're looking like a fucking rock star.
Alright, here we go. Slide to the second verse.
I wanna be great like Elvis.
Amazing.
See, now I feel like playing something different, actually. Let's call an audible here. What about... I feel like playing Hero. I want to do Hero. Let's do that. Shall we? Well, you said you wanted to change shit up. I'm just calling them out. Chucking songs in there. Now we just need the proper guitars. I guess I could have made my mind up before they brought us the guitars. Thanks, buddy. All right, let's try this. Again, I think it's absolutely hilarious. When you write a song like this, the first line is, I am so high, and it makes it into a kid's superhero movie. Ah! That shit makes me giggle. Ah, let's try this, here we go. Together, and we're just kind of hanging out, playing whatevs. However, just because we promised we'd play something off of every record. So now we're going to find out how many diehards are actually in the room. But we got any diehards in the room? All right, cool. So, our first full-length record, which cost us a whopping $5,000 to record. We probably did it in about a week. There's some good riffs on that record, some fun stuff. So we thought we'd take a few different riffs, jam them all together, make a medley, and see if the diehards could figure out what the fuck was going on. Let's see if you guys get this. Here we go.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Play nice. Play nice. Separate the two that don't like each other. Just separate them. Separate the two. Just get somebody over here. We don't need to kick anybody out. Someone over here, someone over there. It's like when you're in the back seat and you start fucking around with your brother. You wind up in the front seat really quick, except your ass hurts. All right, let's get him singing. Have we got it all figured out here? I'll just wait till you guys. You've got your shit in order. All right, kids. All right. Okay. All right. Okay. Hey, you're still arguing with him. Just... Okay. I get all the attention around here. I don't want you distracted. What I really want is I want to get them all singing. Everybody's warmed up. Now we're talking. Oh, I like the sound of this. You guys want to sing one with us? That was pretty half-assed. Do you want to sing one with us? You didn't really have a choice there. I'm just going to scream loud. Here we go. One more time. Give me one more juicy one.
I'd like you to say sorry. Was we not up? This time I'm
thank you. Thank you.
beat. Let's not forget, it's Saturday! Which means I want to party too. Oh, there's a Jager bomb. There's a Jager bomb. There's two Jager bombs just sitting. Oh, sorry. That one's yours. It's got an R on it. It's rated R. Nope, I'll take more. No, no, where are you going, Brad? Don't go anywhere. Don't take the alcohol away. Daddy needs the fucking medicine. I'll even give the cold one. I'll give this to Nicole. I'm not sure exactly where Zach is, but it's gotta be around here somewhere. Nicole, you take that. Yeah, we can do this. Use the force! Thanks for jumping up and singing with us, Nicole. And for the rest of you, Leeds, cheers! Oh, that's delicious. Brad, you could have made it as a fucking bartender easily.
That's a way better gig.
It's a way better gig. I used to bartend until I passed out behind the bar and left my fucking till open. You don't keep your job long after that one. It's like, hey, go home. You're fired. All right, now who wants to get rowdy? I have my James Hetfield looking guitar on. I feel like a fucking badass. The guitar's tuned down to probably A. And if you guys promise to lose your fucking minds, we promise to play Burn It to the Ground. What do you say?